I am Dr. Gopal Chandra Roy. Today I will be presenting a topic on approach to a patient with community acquired pneumonia. Definition of pneumonia: infection of pulmonary parenchyma. It is an acute respiratory illness associated with recently developed radiological pulmonary shadowing, which may be segmental, lobar, or multilobar. Definition of pneumonitis: non-infectious causes of lung inflammation like acid alkali or others corrosive agent. Different type of pneumonia: community acquired pneumonia. An acute infection of pulmonary parenchyma in a patient who has acquired the infection in the community. That means infection outside the hospital. Hospital acquired pneumonia: a new episodes of pneumonia occurring at least 2 days after admission to hospital. Ventilator associated pneumonia: it is a type of hospital acquired pneumonia that develops more than 40 to 72 hours after endotracheal intubation. Aspiration pneumonia: it occurs after a major surgery under general anesthesia or in a patient of semi unconscious or unconscious patient due to aspiration of septic materials. Pneumonia in immunocompromised person: it occurs in a patient in immunocompromised person like long time use of glucocorticoid or AIDS patient. Anatomical types of pneumonia: lobar pneumonia, homogeneous consolidation of one or more lung lobes. Bronchopneumonia, passive foci of consolidation. Factors that predispose to pneumonia: cigarette smoking, upper respiratory tract infection, alcohol, glucocorticoid therapy, old age, recent influenza infection, pre-existing lung disease, HIV, indoor air pollution. Organisms causing community acquired pneumonia: bacteria, Streptococcus pneumoniae, the most common cause of pneumonia, Mycobacterium pneumoniae, Legionella pneumophila, Chlamydia pneumoniae, Haemophilus influenzae, Staphylococcus aureus, Chlamydia citrati, Coxiella barnetii, Klebsiella pneumoniae. Viruses: influenza, parainfluenza, measles, herpes simplex, varicella, adenovirus, cytomegalovirus, coronavirus. Pathological changes: classic pneumonia evolves through a series of pathological changes like stage of consolidation, then red hepatization, then gray hepatization, and stage of resolution. Causes of slow or delayed resolution of pneumonia: delayed resolution means when physical signs persist more than 2 weeks and radiological features persist for more than 4 weeks after antibiotic therapy. And non-resolution means if the radiological features persist for more than 8 weeks after antibiotic therapy. Causes of slow or delayed or non-resolution of pneumonia: incorrect microbiological diagnosis, atypical pneumonia, improper antibiotic, bronchial obstruction like adenoma or carcinoma, empyema, immunocompromised person. Clinical manifestation symptoms: fever with chills and or sweating, cough, initially short, painful, dry, but later is accompanied by expectoration of mucopurulent or rusty colored sputum. Pleuritic chest pain if the pleura is involved. Sign: general exemption, ill looking and toxic, pulse may be raised, BP may be hypotensive, respiratory rate may be increased, temperature raised. Systemic exemption, vary with degree of pulmonary consolidation and presence or absence of significant pleural effusion. Difference between bacterial and viral pneumonia: bacterial pneumonia onset, abrupt, high fever, high grade fever with chills and rigor. In case of viral pneumonia, less abrupt, with history of upper respiratory tract infection and low grade fever, headache and malaise. Cough, initially dry, later becomes productive. In case of viral pneumonia, it is usually dry. Pleuritic chest pain common. In case of viral pneumonia, pleuritic chest pain is less common, but the constitutional symptoms may predominate. physical sign of consolidation, oil marked. In case of viral pneumonia, it's minimal. Leukocyte count, leukocytosis, except atypical pneumonia. In case of viral pneumonia, normal or leukopenia. Chest X-ray, lobar segmental homogeneous opacity with air bronchogram. Mottling, in case of viral pneumonia, there may be mottling, reticular pattern, or passive opacity, or streaky. Blood culture, organism found. In case of viral pneumonia, no organism found. Differential diagnosis of a community acquired pneumonia. Pulmonary tuberculosis, pulmonary infarction, bronchogenic carcinoma, lung abscess, pulmonary edema, COVID-19 pneumonia. Investigation. Complete blood count with ESR. In bacterial pneumonia, polymorphonuclear leukocytosis. In atypical pneumonia, leukocyte count may be normal or slightly increased. In viral pneumonia, there may be leukopenia. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate may be raised. Chest X-ray, lobar pneumonia, homogeneous opacity with air bronchogram, bronchopneumonia, typically patchy and segmental shadowing. Complication, there may be paraneumonic effusion, intrapulmonary abscess, empyema. Staphylococcus aureus, multilobar shadowing, cavitation, pneumatocele, and abscess. Others investigation like pleural fluid aspiration and study, urea and electrolyte. Urea may be more than 7 millimole per liter. It indicates the severity of pneumonia or a marker of severity. Serum electrolyte, there may be hyponatremia, which means there is a chance of syndrome of inappropriate ADH. Liver function test, there may be hypoalbuminemia if basal pneumonia involves the liver. Blood culture, arterial blood gas analysis. It is done when a patient with a saturation less than 93% to detect ventilatory failure or acidosis. Sputum for gram staining, culture and sensitivity. Oropharyngeal swab done for atypical pneumonia. Urine for pneumococcal or legionella antigen. Cold agglutinin positive in 50% of patients with mycoplasma. Site of care of a patient of community acquired pneumonia, any of there may be two tools for detecting the site of care, like pneumonia severity index or CARF 65. In case of CARF 65, like the component of CARF 65 is confusion. Blood urea more than 7 millimole per liter, respiratory rate more than 30 breaths per minute, blood pressure, systolic blood pressure less than 90 millimeter of mercury, or diastolic blood pressure less than 60 millimeter of mercury, is more than 65 years. Score 1.4 is present. CARF 65 score or 0 or 1, home treatment is suitable. Score 2, consider hospital supervised treatment. Option may be include short stay inpatient, hospital supervised outpatient. Score 3 or more, manage in hospital as severe pneumonia, assess for ICU admission, especially if the score 4 or 5. And this is the X-ray of pneumonic consolidation. Management. Oxygen, fluid balance, antibiotic, treatment of pleural pain and physiotherapy. Oxygen, it is indicated in case of hypoxemia, hypotension or acidosis to maintain the partial pressure of oxygen more than or equal 8 kilopascal, saturation of oxygen more than 92%. Fluid balance, it is indicated in case of a severely ill patient or patient of repeated vomiting, or usually in case of patient of unconsciousness. Antibiotic, In case of uncomplicated pneumonia, the duration of antibiotic may be for 5 days. Uncomplicated pneumonia, the antibiotic may be amoxicillin 500 milligram 3 times daily orally. If patient is allergic to penicillin, clarithromycin 500 milligram twice daily orally, or erythromycin 500 milligram 4 times daily orally. If Staphylococcus aureus is cultured or suspected, fluconazoxacillin 1 to 2 gram 4 times daily intravenous, plus clarithromycin 500 milligram twice daily intravenous. Staphylococcus aureus is suspected when there is exudations like pneumatocele cavitation, multilobar shadowing, etc. If mycoplasma or legionella is suspected, clarithromycin 500 milligram twice daily orally or intravenous, or erythromycin 500 milligram 4 times daily orally or IV, plus rifampicin 600 milligram twice daily IV in severe cases. Severe community acquired pneumonia. Clarithromycin 500 milligram twice daily intravenous, or erythromycin 500 milligram 4 times daily intravenous, plus coamoxiclav 1 to 2 gram 3 times daily intravenous, or ceftriaxone 1 to 2 gram daily IV, or cefuroxime 1.5 gram 3 times daily IV, or amoxicillin 1 gram 4 times daily IV, plus fluconazoxacillin 2 gram 4 times daily IV. In case of severe pneumonia, the D drug is clarithromycin. Indication for referral to intensive therapy unit or intensive care unit of a patient of community acquired pneumonia. CARF 65 score of 4 to 5, failing to respond rapidly to initial management. Persisting hypoxia despite high concentration of oxygen. Progressive hypercapnia, severe acidosis, circulatory shock, reduced consciousness level. Complication of pneumonia, like paraneumonic vision, most common, empyema, lobar collapse, deep vein thrombosis and pulmonary embolism, pneumothorax, supportive pneumonia or lung abscess, arrhythmia like atrial fibrillation, hepatitis, pericarditis, myocarditis, meningoencephalitis, ectopic abscess, in case of Staphylococcus aureus, acute respiratory distress syndrome, renal failure, multi-organ failure. Discharge criteria of a patient with a pneumonia from hospital. To discharge, the patient should be clinically stable with not more than one of the following clinical signs. Temperature more than 37.8 degrees centigrade, heart rate more than 100 beats per minute, respiratory rate more than 24 beats per minute, systolic blood pressure less than 90 millimeter of mercury, saturation of oxygen less than 90%, inability to maintain oral intake, abnormal mental status. Thank you.